Russia will roll out its first approved drug for COVID-19 next week. The move will give the healthcare system a boost and help the country's economic revival. The head of Russia's RDIF Sovereign Wealth Fund told Reuters in an interview that Russian hospital could begin giving the antiviral drug, registered under the name Abifavir, to patients from June 11. He said the company behind the drug would produce enough stocks to treat around 60,000 people a month. There is currently no vaccine for COVID-19, and human trials of several existing antiviral drugs have yet to show their efficacy. A new antiviral drug from Gilead called Remdesivir has shown some promise in small efficacy trial against COVID-19 and is being given to patients under compassionate or emergency use rules in some countries. Abifavir, known generally as Favipiravir, was first developed in the late 1990s by a Japanese company, later bought by Fujifilm as it moved into healthcare. Russian direct investment fund head Kirill Dimitrov said Russian scientists had modified and enhanced Abifavir and Moscow would be ready to share the details of those modifications within 2 weeks. Abifavir appeared on a Russian government list of approved drugs on Saturday. Dimitrov claimed that the drug has cured around 330 people within 4 days in clinical trials. However, according to the Reuters reports, while the trials were due to be concluded in around a week, the health department gave the drug approval in haste. Dimitrov said Russia was able to cut testing timescales because the Japanese generic drug, which Abifavir is based on, was first registered in 2014 and had undergone significant testing before Russian specialists modified it. Dimitrov said, "We believe this is a game changer. It will reduce strain on the healthcare system. We will have fewer people getting into a critical condition. We believe that the drug is the key to resuming full economic activity in Russia. With 4,14,878 cases, Russia has the third highest number of infection in the world after Brazil and US. However, the mortality rate is relatively lower, with around 4,855 succumbing to the deadly contagion.